सर आर यू गुड? राम 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 सर।
राम 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 सर,
ओके okay.
परफेक्ट, देयर इज नो इको नाउ, वॉइस इज वेरी
गुरु,
क्लियर।
हाँ, ओमकारम 3 टाइम्स। ओंकारं बिंदु संयुक्तं नित्यं ध्यायन्ति योगिनः कामदं मोक्षदन्तैव ओंकाराय नमो नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात्
गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म
ब्रह्म
तस्मै
तस्मै
श्री गुरु
गुरवे नमः। गुरुरेव गतिः गुरुमेव भजे गुरुणैव सहास्मि नमो गुरवे। न गुरोः परमं शिशुरस्मि गुरोः मतिरस्ति गुरौ मम पाहि गुरो। कार्तस्वरनिभदेहः कीर्तनमात्रेण धूतसकलाघः आर्तस्वरजनशरणं मूर्तदयारूपगुरुवरेण्यो व्यात्। सदात्मध्याननिरतं विषयेभ्यः पराङ्मुखम् नौमि शास्त्रेषु निष्णातं चन्द्रशेखरभारतीं विवेकिनं महाप्रज्ञं धैर्योदार्यक्षमानिधिं सदाभिनवपूर्वन्तं विद्यातीर्थगुरुं भजे। अज्ञानां जाह्नवीतीर्थं विद्यातीर्थं विवेकिनां सर्वेषां सुखदं तीर्थं भारतीतीर्थमाश्रये विद्याविनयसम्पन्नं वीतरागं विवेकिनं वन्दे वेदान्ततत्त्वज्ञं विधुशेखरभारतीम्। शुक्लाम्बरधरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये। अगजाननपद्मार्कं गजाननमहर्निशम् अनेकदन्तं भक्तानां एकदन्तमुपास्महे। वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय कोटिसूर्यसमप्रभा अविघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। वागीशाद्यास्सु मनसः सर्वार्थानामुपक्रमे यन्नत्वा कृतकृत्या स्युः तन्नमामि गजाननम्। Today we will learn two more slokas on Goddess Saraswati. So I will tell, let us all repeat. Saraswati Namastubhyam.
Saraswati Namastubhyam. Saraswati Namastubhyam.
Varade Kamarupini.
वरदे कामरूपिणी वरदे कामरूपिणी
विद्यारम्भम्
विद्यारम्भम् विद्यारम्भम्
करिष्यामि
करिष्यामि करिष्यामि।
सिद्धिर् भवतु मे सदा।
सिद्धिर् भवतु मे सदा। सिद्धिर् भवतु मे सदा।
नमस्ते शारदे देवि।
नमस्ते शारदे देवि। नमस्ते शारदे देवि।
काश्मीरपुरवासिनि।
काश्मीरपुरवासिनि। काश्मीरपुरवासिनि।
त्वामहं प्रार्थये नित्यम्।
त्वामहं प्रार्थये नित्यम्। त्वामहं प्रार्थये नित्यम्।
विद्यां बुद्धिं च देहि मे।
विद्यां बुद्धिं च देहि मे। विद्यां बुद्धिं च देहि मे।
सो ई वुड रिक्वेस्ट दि अटेंडीज आर पार्टिसिपेंट्स टू टेल फ्यू श्लोकास प्लीज रेज योर हैंड्स Arundhati, you are self-muted.
Ram Ram Ram.
Ram Ram Ram, please tell.
Saraswati Namastubhyam Bhavade Kabhavupadi Vidya Vambam Kavashyami Siddhar Bhavatu Me Sada.
Excellent.
अज्ञानं जाह्नवीतीर्थं विद्यातीर्थं विवेकिनां सर्वेषां सुखदं तीर्थं भारतीतीर्थमाश्रये.
एक्सलेंट. सो दट वाज सुभद्रा. सुभद्रा
That was Subhadra. The one who just recited was Subhadra.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Subhadra. Gopika.
Saraswati Namastubhyam Varade Kamarupini Vidyarambham Karishyami Siddhir Bhavatu Me Sada.
Gopika, if I Saraswati, there is a hasm. Saraswati Namastubhyam Varade Kamarupini. So there is a hrasva there and not a dirgha. Vidyarambham Karishyami Siddhir Bhavatu Me Sada. Excellent. Thank you very
okay.
much.
Thank you.
Gayatri Agarwal. Gayatri Agarwal.
Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Deva Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmay Shri Gurave Namaha.
Excellent. I'll come back to you, Subhadra, 1 minute. Aditi Atreya.
ओंकारं बिंदु संयुक्तं नित्यं ध्यायन्ति योगिनः कामदं मोक्षदं चैव ओंकाराय नमो नमः.
वेरी गुड अदिति. वेरी गुड अर्णव शर्मा.
Can you open that Param Brahma shloka on screen please?
Which one?
That Param Brahma, that
Guru Sakshat Parambrahma. Okay, I've opened.
Guru Vish, Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwarat, Guru Sakshat Parambrahma, Tasmai Shri
See, you should practice the pronunciation properly. Gurur Brahma, Brahma, Gurur Vishnuhu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha. So there are subtle improvements which can be made in your pronunciation. Please practice. Thank you very much. Pranavati. The pronunciation is the heart of Sanskrit slokas. Shruti Ram Prasad.
Saraswati. Mr. Jam. Why they come with the Rambam? I shall sit about to visit.
Thank you. Sumalata.
Suklam Bharadaram Vishnam Sasivarnam Chaturpujam Prasanna Vadanam Dhyaye Sarva Vignopasantehe.
So Suklam Bharadaram Vishnam Shashivarnam. It is not Sasivarnam. Shashivarnam.
Okay.
Shashivarnam Chaturbhujam Prasanna Vadanam Dhyaye. So Sarva Vigna Sasivarnam, both are not same. Shuklam Bharad. Can you repeat now?
Suklam Bharadaram
Vishnu. Take one more. I tell you. Shuklam. Bharadharam Vishnum.
Bharadharam Vishnum.
Shashivarnan.
Shashivarnam.
Very good, very good. Shashivarnan Chaturbhujam.
Shashivarnam Chaturbhujam.
Ah, very good. Now your pronunciation is correct. Excellent. Thank you very much. Surabhi Gunjur Satish.
Namaste Sharade Devi Kashmira Puravasini. Swamaham prarthaye nityam vidya buddhim cha dehime.
Vidyam buddhim cha dehime. Vidya buddhim nasti. Vidyam
buddhim cha dehime.
Very good. Sarvesh Kishore.
Saraswati namasdubhyam varade kamarupini vidya rambam karish.
Okay, thank you. So we'll go to the next part, which is the story. Please practice. So we have completed around 13 slokas, including Sharada. No, 14 slokas we have completed. Please practice these slokas with accurate pronunciation. Now let us get into the story. Today's story is the story of Dhruva. Now, Brahma, he created Swayambhuva Manu. This Swayambhuva Manu and Shatarupa are said to be the first couple of the creation of Brahma. Now, Swayambhuva Manu had many sons. One of them was Uttanapada. Uttanapada had, he was a king and he had two wives. The elder wife was called Suniti, and the younger wife was called Suruchi. So, who are the wives of Uttanapada? Can anybody tell? Aditi Atreya.
Suruchi and Suniti.
Who was the elder one? The elder wife was Suniti and the younger wife was Suruchi. Now, the king Suruchi was extremely beautiful and dominating. She was dominating character. So Uttanapada loved Suruchi more. He was very partial towards Suruchi. Suniti had a son named Dhruva. He was the elder son. And Suruchi had a son named Uttama. Dhruva was the elder son. He was the son of Suniti. Uttama was the son of Suruchi and he was younger to Dhruva. Now, in those days, the custom was the elder son should be crowned as the king. So, Suruchi was afraid that Dhruva, son of Suniti, would be crowned as the king. And so what she did, she was very cunning and she used all her influence to be very close to the king and made sure that the king loved only Uttama, who was the younger son, who was also her daughter. Now, when Dhruva was 7 years old, Uttama was one day, he was playing on his father's lap. Dhruva, looking at Uttama playing on his father's lap, ran towards his father and tried, and his father was sitting on the throne, ran towards his father to sit on his lap. Suruchi saw this and she shouted at him and said, "How dare you sit on father's lap? So do you really think you deserve this father's lap and this throne? You will never be the king. You don't deserve this." She scolds Dhruva and she pushes him from that place and he goes away. King Uttanapada was disturbed, but however, he loved Suruchi so much that he dared not to open his mouth against her. So looking that his father was very silent and he did not tell anything, Dhruva was very upset. So he started crying and he ran to his mother. He went to his mother Suniti and told, Suniti asked him, "What makes you cry? Why are you crying?" So Dhruva narrated the entire incident and he asked, am I not eligible to sit on my father's lap? Do I not deserve my father's love? This is what he asks. Suniti, on hearing to Dhruva, cried and she had tears in her eyes. But she could not do anything to help her son. She hugged him and slowly her tears subsided and she wiped the tears from his son's eyes and she cleared the throat and she said, you could have been the king, but because the king loves Suruchi more, he has decided to make Uttama as the next king Now all this you are suffering because you are my son. Now Dhruva listened to his mother and did not say anything. He says, "Mother, I do not want to be, I want to be always your son." And he asks, "Mother, who is this Lord Narayana?" Suniti was surprised. How come Dhruva is asking about Narayana and there is no connection between the narration of the incident and Narayana? She asks him, "Why are you asking this question?" Then Dhruva says, "You know, Suruchi told me that if I wanted to be the king, I must do penance on Lord Narayana, who is the ultimate god and because of whom everything in the world exists. He can do anything and everything, and he can make me born in the womb of Suruchi in the next janma, and therefore I can become the king only in the next janma." So So who is this Lord Narayana? Dhruva asks. Then Suniti says, Lord Narayana is the ultimate Paramatma, and it is very difficult to do penance on him, and you are a very small child, and you can only see him or meet him only if you are devoted to him totally and meditate on him with unswerving devotion. Dhruva says, I will go to the forest and do penance. I will do it. I will make you proud, he says, and he gets up and starts walking towards the forest. Suniti came forward and said, no, you can't go. Forest is not everybody's game. It is very difficult. There'll be wild animals. There'll be so many things in the forest. You can't, you are a small boy. Then Dhruva was determined. He says, I will definitely go and do penance on Lord Narayana and meet him. And then I will come with his blessings. So I will definitely go. He was very determined. So he starts towards the forest. On the way, Dhruva meets. So sage Narada, who is the consort of Lord Vishnu, he learns about, he is a Sarvajna. He has divine powers. So he learns about Dhruva's intention. And he meets him on the way and he wants to help him. He asks Dhruva, where are you going and why are you going? You are a very small boy. Dhruva says, I am going to the forest. I want to meditate on Lord Narayana and take his blessings so that I can achieve the highest power and I can achieve many things in my life. Then Narada had never seen such determination in a young child. So he understood that this Dhruva was very serious, and he asked him, why do you wish to see Lord Vishnu? Then Dhruva narrates the whole story. Then Narada decides to guide him, and he teaches him a mantra. He says, on this mantra, you chant this mantra, and this is how Lord Vishnu looks. While you do penance by chanting this mantra, I am sure Lord Vishnu will appear. So Dhruva joyfully, he thanks Sage Narada. Oh, thank you. I didn't know how to do penance. You taught me so much, so very well. Now I can definitely do the penance. And he sat under a tree. And in the first month of his penance, Dhruva used to eat only fruits. The second month, he gave up fruits also. In the fifth month, by the fifth month, he gave up food and water. Then in the sixth month, he started only taking air as his food. So a fierce light, a tejas, which radiance, started coming from his face. He started seeing Vishnu in his internal vision. He didn't open the eyes. He kept on doing penance. The power of his penance was so great that all the three worlds started shaking. Indra was also worried. Is Dhruva doing penance for Indra Padavi? Then Lord Vishnu, after Lord Vishnu decides to come and appear in front of Dhruva. Lord Vishnu, when he comes and stands in front of Dhruva, Dhruva does not open the eyes. He is seeing Vishnu in his inside. So suddenly what Vishnu does, he makes himself, his form vanishes in the internal vision of Dhruva. So Dhruva suddenly, he misses Vishnu and he suddenly opens his eyes. Then he sees Vishnu in front of him. Very happy, he is very happy that Lord Vishnu has come. So he was thrilled. He opened his eyes to see the most beautiful sight of his life. And he was so happy, he could not get any words from his mouth. So he started praising Vishnu with the help of shlokas. Yontav pravishya mamavacham imam prasuktam. Like that he tells about lot of shlokas. And he fell at the feet of the Lord, not knowing what to do. Then Vishnu says, see, I have come. Your penance has dragged me here. Now tell me, what should I give to you? Dhruva says, I wanted something, but now I don't want anything because I've seen you. I don't need anything. That's what he says. So now Lord Vishnu gave a smile and he embraced the child. He says, okay, I have made to see a devotion closer to you. Do one thing. You go to your kingdom. Be a good ruler. Be a king. And after your rule has ended, you will get a position that from where no one can throw you. Such will be the position that you will get. That is how he blesses Dhruva. And Dhruva suddenly remembers, I just don't want anything. I just want to be with you. Lord Vishnu says, no. You should go home. Your mother, father, everybody are waiting for you. Meanwhile, Narada, he goes and tells Uttanapada that Dhruva is a blessed child and he is a special child. And therefore, you should treat Dhruva properly. And on the advice of Narada, Uttanapada, Suruchi, Suniti, Uttama, Dhruva's elder brother, they all wait for Dhruva's arrival. Dhruva, after taking the blessings of Vishnu, he goes back to his kingdom and sees everybody waiting to welcome him. So he was then the Suruchi also is unhappy that she has sent him to forest. She could not forgive herself, but Dhruva says it is because of her that he could see Vishnu, and he feels happy and he prostrates before her. And Uttama, his brother, younger brother, tells him to be the king. And Uttanapada, Dhruva's father, he makes Dhruva as the king, and he goes to the forest to do penance on Vishnu, penance. So Dhruva ruled the kingdom for a lot of years, and he, along with his younger brother, together they live together very happily. After his rule of 36,000 years, Srimad Bhagavatam says, 36,000 years, Dhruva goes to Vaikuntha, the abode of Lord Vishnu. There, Vishnu makes him a bright star, a star. And he says, you have a place, and you will be called the pole star, Dhruva the pole star. And you will be, nobody can remove you from this place. And Dhruva is positioned in the sky as a star. So because of his devotion, Dhruva attained a permanent place, and he was always one of the very good devotees of Lord Vishnu. Now let us go around and ask for the moral of the story. Can anybody tell the moral of the story? Can you please raise hands? I will ask you. Arunav Sharma.
Am I audible? Am I audible?
Pardon, I couldn't hear you.
Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible.
Narayana is only object of devotion.
Narayana is an object of devotion. Okay, thank you. Can Arundhati Kriti?
Yes. Go ahead, Kriti.
What
did you pray on?
If you pray on Lord Vishnu, anything can happen.
Anything you want
can happen in life.
If you meditate on Vishnu, anything can happen. Only good things will happen. Thank you very much. Anybody else? Gayatri Agarwal. Gayatri Agarwal, you are self-muted, I think.
If you pray to God, he will fulfill all your needs.
If you pray to God, he will fulfill all your needs. Excellent. Gopika.
We should be devoted to God and we should believe in not being greedy.
We should be devoted to God and not be greedy. Excellent. Jai Ganesh Vaidyanathan. You are self-muted, I think.
True devotion can
alone can
win over God.
True devotion alone can win over God. That was excellent. Raghu Alavandar. Yourself.
You have belief in God, anything is possible.
Have belief and trust in God. Okay, anything is possible. Sarvesh Kishore.
The moral of the story is if you pray to God, you can get anything you want.
To pray to God, you can get anything. You can fulfill all your desires. Sharda Narayanan.
It doesn't matter how young you are. If you just have faith, anything is possible.
It doesn't matter how young you are. Dhruva was a young child and he was only 5 years old when he prayed to Lord Vishnu. Doesn't matter how young you are. Great. Anybody else? Vibha Janga. Vibha Janga. Vibha. Krishnamurti. He is self-muted. Okay. Okay, Surabhi.
Whatever happens is for the good.
Whatever happens is for the good. Okay. Excellent. So, thank you very much for the moral. Now, let us go to the next part of the class.
So one more interpretation of the story which Venkat sir used to tell always. All our Hindu stories or the Bhagavata stories have lot of inner meaning to it. So if we just see the story and the characters and also generally to get the inner meaning, if we see the names of these characters, we can understand the inner meaning. So, for example, if we take the first name, Uttanapada. So, he is the son of Swayambhava Manu and Chaturupa. Uttanapada actually represents every one of us in our life. Uttana means one whose legs are a little bit higher, and Pada means legs. So generally, when we are relaxing and sitting, our legs are always a little bit upright. So we are a little bit laid back in life. That is how generally we are when we should actually be sadhakas. And in a normal life when we are leading, we always have two paths in our life. Those are represented by the two wives, Suruchi and Suniti. Suniti, when it says Niti, means moral. So there is always a good moral path in our life, which takes us towards the Almighty. We also have a desire path, the Asha path or the Ruchi, the tasty life. That we have two paths. And for each of these paths, when we have a Suruchi path, where does it take us to is a Uttama Pada. it will take us to a good position in life. It will give us uttama pada, but it will not give us the dhruva or the most stable destination in our life. Only suniti marga will give us dhruva padavi or the most stable position in life. Initially, like any of us, uttana pada will always think suruchi marga is good and I have always attained the uttama position, a very high position in life. And therefore, I am very, very satisfied. But later on, only he realizes that the suniti marga and the dhruva padavi, when I have more discipline and morality and I go through the suniti marga, I get the dhruva padavi, which will take us to Lord Narayana. Only dhruva's marga will take us to Lord Narayana and will truly make us blessed. So this is the inner meaning of the story, which Venkat sir and our parents used to tell us. So hopefully that was helpful to all. Thank you. Ram Ram.
Dhruva also means a person who is strong and who is determined. Dhruvaha certain. Jatasya hi dhruva mrutihu. Dhruva is a certain. So if we are determined, disciplined in our lives, we can achieve anything. Thank you very much, Vishwanath, for reminding these morals. So now we'll get into the next part of the story. The games, we didn't finish the food game. So I will give to Vishwanath. We didn't finish the food game. Did we finish this game last time? Arundhati, did we finish this game?
I don't think so. No, we haven't played this.
Okay. So I'll over to Vishwanath.
सर्वेभ्यः राम 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 इदानीं अस्माकं नूतन क्रीडां कुर्मः ओके सो इदानीं दक्षिण भारतीय भोजनार्थं सूक्तान पाकान चिनुत सो आवर मदर हियर शी वांट्स हेल्प इन आइडेंटिफाइंग what are the right dishes to serve for a South Indian meal? She wants our help in serving a South Indian meal so that all of us can enjoy a traditional South Indian meal. So what I'll do is I'll unmute. You can tell what all will come into this and then we will take and start serving those each of the items actually. Okay. So some of us are, I think, self-muted. I'm trying to answer. So one by one, we can. Okay. Arnav Sharma, first word.
Temanam,
yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, what is Temanam? Temanam is kadi in Hindi. It is curd sambar or whatever we can call it as temanam. Okay. Next, Shashkuli agachativa nagachativa. Arundhati is self muted. We'll go to Bhargavi Devi. Saraha comes. Okay, very good. Rasam. Bhargavi. Payasam is good. Okay. Next. What is Shashkuli?
Almana.
Okay. Now, Ravali Balur. Devi Uma Shankar.
Annam.
Annam, avashyakam. Annam vina kimapi kartum na shakyate. Annam eva pratham bhavati. Annam. Astu. Agre. Gayatri Agarwal. Gayatri Agarwal, Takram, Astu, Buttermilk, Anantaram, Ravali Balur, Sarvesh Kishore.
Palapal.
Palapakaha is the one which is there. What or Pullapuraha? I don't know which one are you referring to. First row, last one, or first column, or second column, last one. Palapakaha or Pullapuraha?
Palapakaha.
Palapakaha. As the word denotes, just try to decode the word. Phala is fruits. Pakaha, something which is prepared after cooking the fruits well, which comes to jam actually. So in a traditional South Indian meal, do we have jam? That is generally comes in a continental meal kind of a thing where we have bread, butter, jam.
Okay.
Right. So if I try phala pakaha, it will come back. It won't allow me to put it there.
Yes. Phala pakaha.
Okay.
Okay, next one.
Shakuli.
Vibha Janga. I was thinking. Sharada Narayanan.
Mishrannam,
very good. Mishrannam is any kind of chitrannam, what we do. Mixed rice. Okay. Next.
Avalehaha
is, I'm keeping it here, pickle. Okay.
Chakalehaha.
What is chakalehaha and does it come in a traditional South Indian meal? Chakaha is that which we can, chaka is which we can actually enjoy with that chaka sound. Leha is lihya, which is in the form of a lehya types. So that is chocolate actually. Chaka leha means chocolate, which we generally don't use in a South Indian meal. We don't do. Okay, probably after meal we can use it as a dessert. Shashkuli. Okay, let us see. Shashkuli, yes. What they do is in between in the South Indian meal, some bonda shashkuli, sometime they add one of these. Festival days they add, so we can take that. Next.
Pullapur.
Next.
Kvattim.
Excuse me, huh? Krishna.
Kvattim. Kvattim.
Kvatitam. Okay. This is Kvatitam, which is sambar. Okay, we've kind of finished all. Kvatitam is sambar. Excuse me. Now we are going to a North Indian meal. Okay, rotika. Okay, that is the point. Okay, next. Anybody who wants to
Purika.
Purika. Okay, rotis and puris. Very good.
Annam.
Annam. Annam.
Vyanjanam.
What is Vyanjanam?
Kari.
Vyanjanam. Kari. Okay, so Vyanjanam. I have unmuted Devi Arundhati. I have unmuted.
Avalehaha.
Yeah, pickle.
Avalehaha. Okay, avalehaha, of course, comes in both the meals. Then?
Parpataha.
Very good. Papad is a very important side dish in North Indian food. Parpataha, which is papad. Okay.
Dadikam.
Dadikam.
Dadikam. Very good. What is dadikam?
Lassi.
Very good.
One is
Rasa Golakam. What is Rasa Golakam?
Rasgulla.
Okay, Rasgulla we have added. Okay. Kriti.
Krisaraha.
Krisaraha. What is Krisaraha?
Kichdi.
Ah, Kichdi. So with the dal and rice, they prepare a khichdi, which is very good and very tasty actually. Okay. Next. I've unmuted quite a few of us. Those who have raised hands, I have unmuted. Feel free to tell the answer. Next one.
Supaha.
Supaha is pulse or that pulses. So that is taken. All the other ones which were there did not belong to the North Indian meal, and we have successfully completed. So one of the, like what Venkat sir told in the previous class, one of the main objectives of finishing this part of the games, which is food and the related games, was in a day we can all decide that we will speak in Sanskrit. Vayam samskrita bhashayam eka ghanta va ardha ghanta va sambhashanam kurmaha. We can decide we'll speak in Sanskrit for half an hour, and the easiest time to speak in Sanskrit will be dinner time, when all of us are together generally. And all the items of food which are there are present in this section. Tada asmabhi vaktum shakyate. He mataha annam pariveshayatu. Please serve food. Kvatitam pariveshayatu. Temanam pariveshayatu. We can tell that. And if we want more, itopi avashyakam alam. Alam is enough. So using these transactionary words and the words used in this section, we can all discuss saying, okay, we will, during dinner time, let us speak in Sanskrit. That is the main objective of doing this section of games. So in case you already have this vocabulary product, please go through and let us know your experience as to how your dinner time goes on, and how you can help mother serve, or also you can converse in Sanskrit during dinner time. Dhanyavadaha. Idanim agre gachamah, idanim samskrita geetani. Okay. Super. Okay. So quickly we will do the revision games only once. And then we will go to the rhymes for today as per what time permits. So let's all together do the Ramahayati rhyme. Or we can also go with the audio itself. And we can go with the audio, and all of us can do together. Ekam dve trini prarambha. I hope all of you are ready for Ramahayati, first game, first rhyme.
Ramahayati, Ramahayati, Sitaya Saha, Sitaya Saha,
Kutra sahayati, kutra sahayati, sarayunadi, sarayunadi. Krishna hayati, Krishna hayati, Radhaya saha, Radhaya saha, kutra sahayati, kutra sahayati, Yamuna nadim, Yamuna nadim. Vithala hayati, Vithala hayati, Rukminya saha, Rukminya saha, kutra sahayati, kutra sahayati, Chandrabhaga, Chandrabhaga. Beautiful. I hope all of you also did along with me and enjoyed it. Second rhymes, a very, very enjoyed rhyme again. This is on the our parts of body. So start with, be careful. The first action is mama, mai, dasha. You have to show like this. Mama, dasha, angulyaha. Okay. So hope all of us remember this. This also will go with the audio itself. Yeah. One, two, three. Prarambha hai dani. कुर्मः इदानीं मिलित्वा कुर्मः होप् आल् आफ् अस् आर् रेडी मम दश सारी अङ्गुल्यः द्वे मम नेत्रे एका दीर्घा नासिका द्वौ मम कर्णौ दश अङ्गुल्यः द्वे मम नेत्रे एका दीर्घा नासिका वौ मम कर्णौ बहवः दन्ताः एका जिह्वा एकं वदनं देवकीर्तनाय बहवः दन्ताः एका जिह्वा एकं वदनं देवकीर्तनाय ब्यूटिफुल् रैम् which gives an inner meaning saying all the parts of the body which we have is for Deva Kirtanaya. Now coming on to the next one, Gaja Ayahi, I think this was taught last week. We will look into this. We have the Gaja coming here. So let us play along with the audio. Hope all of us are ready to be the Gaja. Gaja ayahi, gaja ayahi re. Those who are standing can stand and do it. Ayahi, gaja ayahi re. Gaja ayahi.
Udaram
lambam asti. The udaram like this.
Ud. Dantau shundadika asti.
Karnau vitatau staha.
Udaram
lambam asti. Dantau sitau staha.
Shundadika asti. Karnau vitatau staha.
Gaja ayahi, gaja ayahi re. Gaja ayahi, gaja ayahi, gaja ayahi re. This is a tail.
Uccham. Kayam bandham asti.
Padastham hasanti.
Uccham asti.
Netre alpe staha.
Kayam bandham asti. Padastham hasanti. Gaja ayahi, gaja ayahi, gaja ayahi re.
Okay, so we had gaja ayahi also coming. Just conscious of time, I will quickly hand over to Manoj sir for the bhajans. Next week we will spend a little bit more time on the rhymes. Till then, keep practicing. Dhanyavadaha. Over to you, Manoj sir.
Ram Ram Ram. जानकीकान्तस्मरणम् जय जय राम राम हर नमः पार्वतीपतये हर हर महादेव गोपिका जीवनस्मरणम् गोविन्द गोविन्द सद्गुरुस्वामी की जय आञ्जनेयस्वामिनः जय गजानना हे शुभानना गजानना हे शुभानना गौरी मनोहर प्रियनन्दना गौरी मनोहर प्रियनन्दना पशुपतितनया गजानना पशुपतितनया गजानना हे परम निरंजन शुभानना हे परम निरंजन शुभानना गजानना हे शुभानना गौरी मनोहर प्रियनन्दना पशुपतितनया गजानना पशुपतितनया गजानना परम निरंजन शुभानना हे परम निरंजन शुभानना गजानना हे शुभानना गौरी मनोहर प्रियनन्दना विनायकमूर्ति की जय Can you go to the next bhajan?
Amba Bhavani Sharade Jagadamba Bhavani Sharade Amba Bhavani Sharade Jagadamba Bhavani Sharade
Shankara Pujita Sharade
Shankara Pujita Sharade
शङ्कर पूजिते शारदे
शङ्कर पूजिते शारदे
गङ्गनिवासिनि शारदे
गङ्गनिवासिनि शारदे
शृङ्गनिवासिनि शारदे
गङ्गनिवासिनि शारदे
पुस्तकहस्ते शारदे
पुस्तकहस्ते शारदे
वीणापाणि शारदे
वीणापाणि शारदे
पुस्तकहस्ते शारदे
पुस्तकहस्ते शारदे
वीणापाणि शारदे
वीणापाणि शारदे
मयूरगमनि शारदे
मयूरगमनि शारदे
हंसवाहिनि शारदे
हंसवाहिनि शारदे
मयूरगमनि शारदे
मयूरगमनि शारदे
हंसवाहिनि शारदे
हंसवाहिनि शारदे
अम्बा भवानि शारदे जगदम्बा भवानि शारदे
अम्बा भवानी शारदे जगदम्बा भवानी शारदे
शङ्कर पूजित शारदे
शङ्कर पूजित शारदे
शृङ्गनिवासिनि शारदे
शृङ्गनिवासिनि शारदे
पुस्तकहस्ते शारदे
पुस्तकहस्ते शारदे
वीणापाणि शारदे
Vina Pani Sharade.
Mayura Gamani Sharade.
Mayura Gamani Sharade.
Hamsavahini Sharade.
Hamsavahini Sharade.
Amba Bhavani Sharade.
Amba Bhavani Sharade.
Jagadamba Bhavani Sharade.
Jagadamba Bhavani Sharade.
Adeviki
Jai.
Janaki Kantasmarma. Kartike Masti. வெற்றிவேல் முருகனுக்கு ஹரஹரோ ஹர. கார்த்திகேயா கலியுக வரதா.
கார்த்திகேயா கலியுக வரதா.
கார்த்திகேயா கலியுக வரதா.
கார்த்திகேயா கலியுக வரதா.
கந்தா குமரா கருணாகரனே.
கந்தா குமரா கருணாகரனே.
கந்தா குமரா கருணாகரனே.
கந்தா குமரா கருணாகரனே.
வேல் வேல் முருகா வெற்றிவேல் முருகா.
வேல் வேல் முருகா வெற்றிவேல் முருகா.
வேல்வேல் 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 முருகா வெற்றிவேல் முருகா.
வாவா முருகா வடிவேலழகா.
வாவா முருகா வடிவேலழகா.
வாவா முருகா வடிவேலழகா.
வாவா முருகா வடிவேலழகா.
கார்த்திகேயா கலியுக வரதா.
கார்த்திகேயா கலியுக வரதா.
கந்தா குமரா கருணாகரனே.
கந்தா குமரா கருணாகரனே.
வேல்வேல் முருகா வெற்றிவேல் முருகா.
வேல்வேல் முருகா வெற்றிவேல் முருகா.
வாவா முருகா வடிவேலழகா.
வாவா முருகா வடிவேலழகா. வாவா முருகா வடிவேலழகா.
கார்த்திகேயா கலியுக வரதா.
கார்த்திகேயா கலியுக வரதா.
கந்தா குமரா கருணாகரனே.
கந்தா குமரா கருணாகரனே.
வேல் முருகா வெற்றிவேல் முருகா.
வேல்வேல் முருகா வெற்றிவேல் முருகா.
வேல்வேல் முருகா வெற்றிவேல் முருகா.
வேல்வேல் முருகா வெற்றிவேல் முருகா.
வெற்றிவேல் முருகனுக்கு ஹரஹரோ
நாம்.
சமாப்தம்பா.
தன்யவாதாஹ அம்போத் மகோதயா. தன்யவாதாஹ. சர்வே கிருபையா க்ஷம்யந்து. வி டுக் 7 மினிட்ஸ் எக்ஸ்ட்ரா. Apologies for the delay. धन्यवादाः सर्वेभ्यः ये अत्र भागं स्वीकृतवन्तः. ये अनन्तरं तत्र पश्यन्ति एतत् रेकार्डिङ्ग् दृष्ट्वा कक्षाम् अनुभवन्ति तेभ्यः अपि अत्यन्तं धन्यवादाः. वी हेव् एक्चुलि सेण्ट् अ स्माल् सर्वे टु आल् आफ् अस् दोस् हु हेव् रिजिस्टर्ड् बिकास् वी हेव् अरौण्ड् 360 रिजिस्ट्रेशन्स् एण्ड् ओन्ली 35 आफ् अस् आर् एबल् टु अटेण्ड्. वि जस्ट् वाण्ट् टु नो whether the timing is right or should we change the timing, or the format is right or should we change the format, or any other aspects or any feedback you have, please go through the survey and please give us your feedback. Based on that, we can improve further and make this class more useful, more beneficial and more engaging and interactive to all of us. अत्यन्तं धन्यवादाः लॉट्स ऑफ थैंक्स टू एवरीबडी हु हैव अटेंडेड सर्वेभ्यः मंगलानि भवन्तु नेक्स्ट क्लास इज ऑन May 12th, which is a Saturday, same time, 6:30 to 7:30 India time. Guru Reva Gatihi, Guru Meva Bhaje, Guru Naiva Sahasmi Namo Gurave, the Guru of Paramam Shishurasmi Guru, Matirasti Guru, Mama Pahi Guru, Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha, Sarve Santu Niramayaha, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Makaschit Dukha Bhag Bhavet, Kale Varshatu Parjanyaha, Prithivi Sasya Shalini, देशोयं क्षोभरहितः ब्राह्मणाः सन्तु निर्भयाः